Well, good evening. We welcome you to this Thanksgiving Eve service. So we do. You're going to notice that in the front there are several candles that are placed. These are thank candles this evening. Well, sometime during the service, if you have something that you're thankful for, it doesn't matter what it is, we're going to ask that you come forward and light a candle. Now, if you can't do that, you can ask someone else to light the candle for you. You're not going to tell anybody what you're thankful for. But each one of these candles represents something that we are thankful for. Maybe through the year, maybe something happened today. Okay, so anytime during the service, doesn't matter when it is. You know, don't be embarrassed. Just get up, just come forward and light it. And I know that the first one, once someone does it, someone will follow. So someone has to be the brave soul in order to go first. Yes, okay? But we welcome this morning, or this evening, I should say. Excuse me. I'm not used to this evening service in the house of the Lord this morning. Hey, I want to give you the definition of thanks, then give you the definition of give. What Webster says. Thanks, an expression of gratitude, grateful, acknowledgement of something received by or done for one. The definition of give is this. You might have to play with them a little bit. Make a gift, to hard or pass over into trust. To hand or pass over into trust or keeping something. That's the definition of thanks and giving. So it is. My plans always don't work out, my friends. Here you go. You can light this one, okay? Well, it lit, but it didn't. Here, press down on it and light it. Press straight down on it. Press straight down on that and light it. You have to hold it. All right, we'll work at this as we go along, won't we, Ruth Ann? Here's the definition of thanksgiving. When you take thanks and you take giving and put them together, here's the definition of thanksgiving, according to Webster. To act of giving thanks, an expression of this, a formal, it says, often public expression of thanks to God in the form of a prayer. Someone has a lighter, it'll work out just fine. So it will. You can light off another one. I don't know why Bonnie can't use that. Here, push the button down. Push it straight down. Boy, I didn't know it's going to be this hard. You think he's having trouble with music, Becky? Or light it off another one even, if you have to. Okay? But that's when you take thanks and giving, the two examples of give thanks and give, then you bring them over and put them together, an expression of a form or a public expression of thanks. This evening, we celebrate this Thanksgiving. We celebrate it and we give thanks to God for everything that he's done for us, but what he's going to do with us too. And we're so grateful for that. So let us stand. Well, wait a minute now. Wait a minute. I got something else I got to do for you too. I have a question for you this evening, like I want you to answer. What does Thanksgiving mean to you? What does Thanksgiving mean to you? Anyone? Anyone else? What's Thanksgiving mean to you? Come on. What does Thanksgiving mean to you? I have to tomorrow morning. Well, lunchtime tomorrow. Okay, let's say that. Lunchtime tomorrow. So what's Thanksgiving mean to you, though?
Family tradition.
Right. Thanksgiving means something different to everyone here. It means family. It means tradition. It just thankful what God has given us. Even memories of those memories in years gone past. And we share all those things during this time of year, don't we? We share the goodness that we have. We even share the lean times that we have with each other. But one thing we all have in common as Christians, we share Christ with each other. And we share Christ in the world around us as we go through this world. And this evening, we've come to celebrate that and give thanks to God for everything that he's done for us and everything that he will do with us. So I'm going to invite you to stand with me. And we're going to have a call to worship. The call to worship is going to be taken from Psalms chapter 9, verses 1 and 2 this evening. And it says, I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart, and I will tell of your wonders. And I will be glad and exalted in you.
I will sing praise to your name, O Most High.
Did you hear what it says? It says, I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart. Now, the scriptures don't say, I give thanks with a half of my heart, a quarter of my heart. And it says, all my heart. And I will tell of all your wonders. What's your wonders? Your wonders is the thanks that you give God each and every day, how he meets your needs and does everything. Well, this evening we're going to join in. He has made me glad. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. Let's sing, ladies. Can we sing the chorus? Again? Sing the chorus again.
He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
Father, we come before you this evening, and you have made us glad. Father, we thank you for this Thanksgiving season where we can just say thank you to each other and thank you to you for what you've done for us. Father, we know that you sent your Son in the world to die on the cross so we may have eternal life. And Father, we're so grateful and thankful for that. Now, Father, be with every aspect of this service, dear Lord. And Father, this service will be molded and shaped into what you want it to be, not what man wants it to be, Lord. Father, we thank you for the opportunity that you have given us. But Father, again, we pray as we do each and every Sunday morning, dear Lord, we pray this evening that if there's one that doesn't know you as personal Savior, they're here or watching us this evening, we would ask in your precious name that Jesus Christ would enter their hearts, and Father, they would find you maybe for the very first time. Bless us and be with us and touch us, Lord. And Father, we thank you. And Father, we ask everything in your name. Amen and amen. You may be seated. As we continue this evening and as we give thanks, we just remember all those good times, don't we? Remember all the lean times in life. Remember what God has done for us and what God has met our needs, even during heartache and pain and agony. There's always something to give thanks to God for. And we can celebrate that. And we're here this evening just for this next song, what we're going to sing. I just came to praise the Lord. What do you have to praise God about today? See, this is an interactive service this evening. Do you notice that? What do you have to praise God about today, for today? Go ahead. He just got hired at Taco Bell. If you want free tacos, no, I'm just joking. He just got hired at Taco Bell. That's a praise. Congratulations. What else? What do you have to praise God for today? Go ahead. You're alive? Amen to that. Yes, amen to that. What else? Bonnie? Grandbabies? Sure, grandbabies, yes. Bonnie? Yeah, faithful partner in life. Donna? Tom? Yes, definitely. What else? What do you have to praise God? Go ahead. What's that? MRI come back clear? That's definitely a praise. Yeah. Amen. Debbie. Okay, new Christian friends, they were sent from heaven. Yeah, praise God for that. What else? What do you praise God about? Ladies before... Family and friends and the fellowship we have here? Sure. Praise God. Anyone else? See, there's always something. There's always something to praise God for. Whether it be just the MRI coming back, a job, being alive, grandbabies, spouses, Christian friends, or I mean just the weather. That's a praise too. We have everything that we have. We can praise God for everything that we have. Why? Because God has provided it. Now, it may not go the way we think it goes, right? We may think it should go a little different, right? But there's always something to praise God for. And we have to remember that. There's always something to give thanks to God for within our life just because of who He is. And just because of what He does in our lives each and every day. I think sometimes as Christians, we take that a little bit too lightly. Would you agree with that? We take that a little bit too lightly. But He wants to hear our praise because our praise is our testimony to who God is and what God does for us. This evening, we have the ministry of music. Light a candle, if you can get it lit. Oh, there's a smart woman. I will say this, and just because you came up once, if you think of something else, you can come up, and you can light another one.
So Thanksgiving to me is a time of reflection. And through my life, I've had lots of ups and downs. But I will say one thing. God has always been there, every single time, no matter what I've been going through. And He's gotten me through it. So you can't have a better friend a confidant. He's everything to me. And I just want to bless him and thank him for all that he's done for me. Go ahead, Jason.
I may never climb a mountain so I can see the world from there. I may never ride the waves and taste the salty ocean air, or build a bridge that would last 100 years. But no matter where the road leads, one thing is always clear.
And aren't we blessed? Can you say amen to that? Amen. We are blessed. Hey, we're going to sing a small chorus, and we're going to sing chorus Sanctuary, and we're going to sing it the first time, as you usually do with the music. The second time, we're going to sing it a cappella. Okay, Sanctuary.
Thank you.
see me. These candles on the altar are going to represent one thing. They represent the light of Christ, but also this evening, these candles are going to represent those people who are no longer with us, those people who are in the splendor of heaven, who are in the glory of God. Did you get it? In every way. They represent our loved ones who are gone, but they celebrate with us this evening as they sing with the angels in heaven. You know, Thanksgiving is a good day to count your blessings, isn't it? A very good day to count your blessings. But have you ever wondered why only one day? Just one day out of the year do we even talk usually about Thanksgiving? Why not a week of Thanksgiving? Or why not several times a year have Thanksgiving? The only thing that's more puzzling than having only one day to give thanks is the Apostle Paul's suggestion that we should give thanks all the time. In 1 Thessalonians, he said this, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." In Christ Jesus. Be joyful always and give thanks for all things. In Philippians, Paul said that we should rejoice always. And again, I say, rejoice, rejoice. Which is even more amazing, since Paul wrote this while he was in prison. In the passage today, Paul says there is nothing that can keep him from having gratitude for God. Paul would have had Thanksgiving every day, with or without turkey, with or without pie, with or without cranberry sauce, and all the other things that most of us will have tomorrow. But you know, sometimes giving thanks can be difficult, can't it? Sometimes giving thanks can be hard within this world around us. We may want to say thank you, but for one reason or another, it can be hard within our lives. Someone once said this, and you've heard this saying many times over the years in your life probably, it's better to give than to receive. And maybe, just maybe, it's not only better, but maybe it's just easier to give than to receive. Think about it just a little bit. When we receive, we are kind of obligated, aren't we? We're kind of obligated. It can be hard to receive. We may feel like we are needy or weak when we receive. Most of us do not like the feeling of being obligated, do we, to anyone or anything within this world. So it's easier to give. Sometimes it's even more than that. Giving thanks can actually sometimes, for some people, be painful. Be painful within their lives. Thank you can be painful. There's a familiar story in the scriptures where Jesus healed 10 lepers. You know the story. But one of them returned to give thanks. But the question's always been, why only one? Why only one? That just doesn't seem right, does it? Only one come back. That just doesn't seem right. But if we understood the life of a leper, life of a leper, maybe it would make sense just a little bit. Think about it just for a moment. Think about it. about a leopard's life and how they had to live. It wasn't fun to be a leper at all. It wasn't just the leprosy that made it bad. It made a person feel sick. It was more than that. My friends, leperhood was a broken way of life in Jesus' day. People didn't socialize with lepers, which you know that. There was no family reunions. There was no Thanksgiving dinner. There was no tailgating party. There was no laughing or no talking in the kitchen. There was just one thing: isolation from the rest of the population. Well, the scriptures tells us that Jesus was walking down the street, and he looked up. He looked up and he saw not one, but he saw 10 lepers that day. He cleansed them all. He cleansed them all. But only one returned. But why only one? That's the question again. Why only one? Maybe after years, maybe this is some of the things. Maybe after years of begging, being shunned, or maybe expecting to say thank you for every little scrap that they get. It is easy to imagine how lepers might have gotten tired of saying thank you. They just got tired of being expected to appreciate the least little bit of kindness within their lives. Maybe their hearts were hardened. Being isolated all the time, it didn't leave them with a feeling of gratitude, did it? Or gratefulness, or thanksgiving, probably. It left them feeling bitter. So they weren't saying thank you to anyone anymore. And you want to know something? They were not going to say thank you even to Jesus for anything. The amazing thing isn't that only one returned. The amazing thing is that even one did return. See, giving thanks had to become too difficult for the lepers in those days. In the passage today, and many others, the Apostle Paul tells us to give thanks so much as we can, I should say. He must have known how hard it could be within our lives, but he still found a way. I don't think Paul is an unrealist. I don't think he is one of those people who don't understand suffering. Paul knew what it meant to be hungry. He knew what it meant to be in pain. He knew what it meant to be beaten and whipped and criticized. And yet, after all of that within his life, after all of that, every aspect of his life, he was able to give thanks in all things, even from prison. Even from prison. I don't know about you. Would you like to have that kind of gratitude? Would you like to be happy for what you have, rather than say, someday I will be happy when I get what I want? What I want. Have you ever said that? I'll be happy when I get everything that I want in the world around us. Have you ever said that? In some way, probably all of us, one point in our life as a kid or someplace, probably said that at some point, at some avenue of our lives. I believe Paul was saying that God's will helps us to be happy, have gratitude, feel blessed, even when we don't have anything we want. I want what Paul has. He found joy. He found thanksgiving, even in prison. If Paul can find joy, my friends, surely we can find joy. Hear what I said? If Paul could find joy in the beatings that he took, in the criticism they took, in the prisons that he suffered in, and all the other things in his life, if he could find joy, surely we in America can find joy. As tough as our lives are, and they might be today, my guess is they're not as tough as what Paul had. They're not as tough as what Paul had. You know, have you ever met that person who is bubbly joy all the time? That no matter what happens in their life, they're smiling, they're laughing. It doesn't matter what happens in their life. They just feel with joy all the time. It seems like that person is born happy. Born happy. They were born happy. They were born with a thankful attitude. They are the neatest people to be around. Because you want to know something? You'll never hear a negative word come out of their mouth. Because no matter what happens in life, they are joyful. They are thankful. But what's the other perspective? Or spectrum, I should say. For those who are not born thankful, there is a way. There is a way. I believe it is as easy as it is hard. The leper gave thanks because Luke said he saw. That's what Luke says. He saw. He really saw. He was healed. I'm sure he still had scars on his hands, maybe in his feet, maybe on his face. But the leper was able to look and find something good. If you and I are able this evening, not just this evening, every day of our lives, if we are able to look at our life and find something good, that is the start of a grateful heart. That's the start of a grateful heart. Regardless of what is going on in our lives today, my friends, there is always something. Believe me, please. There is something for which we can give thanks. We can give thanks. You know, thanks, I heard someone say one time, thanks is an infection. It's like a virus, but it's a good virus of giving thanks. And once you do it, it spreads. Remember the song, "It Only Takes a Spark to Get a Fire Going"? It only takes a spark to get one flame going. Once we have found one thing to be thankful for, you know what happens? You will discover, I will discover another and another and another and another, and the list goes on and on and on. See, I believe that is what Paul did. That is what Paul did. There are all kinds of ways we can do this. But one way is to realize just how many blessings we really have. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Just think tonight, before you laid your head on the pillow, you started to count your blessings. Let me share something. You'd probably be up all night. You don't realize that, though. When you really, really, really start to think of the blessings in your life and you start to count them, you'll be overwhelmed by how many times God has really blessed you. All kinds of ways. There are all kinds of ways that we can do this. But one way is to realize just how many blessings we really have. Let me just give you one example. And this includes everyone here almost. Well, except some of the kids probably. And you understand why. If you have a home, and earn more than $1,000 a year. That includes everyone here, right? More than $1,000 a year. You are better off than 85% of the world's population. Hear what I said? If you have a home and you earn more than $1,000 a year, you are better off than 85% of the world's population. The world's population. In the world's standards, my friends, you and I are rich. We are rich. If we believe God is blessing us, we will see a blessing, and we will see His blessings for us within this world. There was an author one time who wrote a book. And in her book, she talked about her first house that she ever owned in her life. She said it was not a great house. She and her husband only had so much money. And she started to explain about this house and started to give every little details about the house. She says the wallpaper was peeling off. There were leaks in the bathroom, and the kitchen was too small. She said, almost every night, she said, she went to sleep crying because the house just was so awful. Then one day, she went on to explain, one day, by inspiration, she decided something. And this is what she decided. She decided to thank God for that little house, that little house. She thanked Him for the wallpaper peeling off. She thanked Him for the leaky bathroom sink and the pipes. She thanked Him for the small kitchen that she had and she used each and every day. She said at first, it didn't seem to help very much. Nothing took place. Nothing happened. We worked at it, and the same thing happened over and over and over. But after a period of time, she noticed she didn't cry as much. Then it seemed somehow the thanking gave her the energy to start fixing the wallpaper again, start to fix the leaky pipes in the bathroom again, and start adjusting to the kitchen, the very small kitchen. After a period of time, and it wasn't an instant period of time, it was a very, very long period of time, she began to love that house. She began to love the house. It might be as easy and as hard as that. Maybe like the lepers, 9/10 of the time, we won't see the blessing. But maybe 1/10 of the time, we will see the blessing. We pray with God's Spirit. When we pray with God's Spirit, and we look to God, and if we look for the blessings, we may see them. We may realize our health is good. Our sense of mobility is good. Our sound is good that we hear with. And we thank God for the friends, the feeling of the sunshine upon our face, or the tender hugs around our body when someone holds us and tells us that they love us. Or hear the laughter of children in our house, in the house of God. Or the sweet sound of music in the air. Those are all blessings. Those are all blessings. So they are in every way. These candles are not all lit. But these candles represent thanks and thanksgiving. But if you notice, These candles do one thing. These candles illuminate the darkness of this world, don't they? The darkness of this world in every way. If this world, if we would give praise and thanks to God with a grateful heart more than we do each and every day, my friends, you and I can illuminate this darkened world the same as these candles illuminate this house of worship this evening. Because of a grateful heart, we give him praise. Just think, if we did that, and how much we would illuminate the world around us, and how many people would see Jesus more than ever in this world around us. So I pray this, Thanksgiving. You will find one thing, just one thing maybe, to be thankful for. Because then, I believe, that will lead you to thank to thank God for something else in your life. In your life, my friends. And together, we will illuminate the darkness of this world, and people will see Jesus Christ within this world and all around us. This evening, as we close, we're going to sing the song, Give Thanks. And the song is, Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart. How grateful is your heart this evening as we sing this song together? Let's stand and let's sing. Give thanks with a grateful heart. From Sue and I to you, we hope you have the best Thanksgiving you ever had, from our house to your house. We hope that you can be thankful for the God what he's given you, and each and every day you thank him, not just one day out of the year, but you thank him each and every day of your life. May God bless you. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for who you are. We thank you for the things that you do within our life. And Father, we'd ask in your precious name that you enrich our life. And as we leave this sanctuary, dear Lord, that Father, we can take your presence with us. We can take our thanks with us. And as we do, people will see Jesus Christ within our lives to make this world just a little better. And Father, we ask everything in Christ's name. Amen and amen. Thank you for joining us this morning at Center Breath, the Church of God. Our prayer is that the message has uplifted you and has touched your heart. Our prayer is that the songs have lifted your spirits up today and give you encouragement. You know, here at Center Breath, we're involved in the community, and we'll be involved in the community more. And there's several ways we do that through our outreach now. But if you'd like to be a part of the ministry and give to that, there's several ways you can do that. First of all, if you're physically here, you can give it in the offering box. Or secondly, if you're watching us by streaming, you can go to cbcog.org and push on the online giving button. You know, through your gracious giving, that helps us stream our messages out, not only to the local community, but beyond that. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your giving. Our prayer is that Jesus Christ has affected your life and you become a new creation. Thank you, and God bless.